As happened at the beginning of the pandemic and has so often happens in the midst of emergencies, there are those who would prey on the fears of people in the midst of a pandemic like this and take advantage of them by jacking up the prices, for example, of COVID home tests.
The city of LA is taking action after reports of price gouging on at-home COVID tests.
LA City Attorney Mike Fuhrer joins us now to talk more about the efforts to fight price gouging.
Mr. Fuhrer, thanks so much for taking your time today and talking more about this with us.
Of course, it's great to be with you.
All right, first, we've often heard, you know, of people looking to take advantage of others and try to profit during these times of need. What kind of stories are coming into your office regarding this?
So we're just starting to hear stories about potential price gouging. What we're hearing a little bit about is people who are charging in excess of what the state's price gouging rules allow. And let me describe what that means. Governor Newsom just issued an order on price gouging. That means that if a test seller was selling a test before his order, which was January 8th, they can't increase the price by more than 10%. If the seller was not engaged in the sale before his order, then they can sell it for 50% greater than their cost, but that's all. And you know that the average price of a test kit, like the one I'm holding here, is between $10 and $20. So it's a good thing for our viewers to learn that if you're purchasing a test kit with two kits in it, and it might cost $30 or $40 or $50, that's meaningfully more than the price likely was before the emergency order. And I want our viewers to contact our office so we can take action, because there are two different issues here. One is a consumer could get ripped off, but the other is what price gouging does, and it sends a signal to the community that you should panic, because these are getting more and more expensive, it'll be in shorter and shorter supply, and that is not good for anyone right now. So please contact our office if you see signs of this. I would much rather prevent price gouging in the first place than have to vindicate someone's rights when they're a victim afterwards.
Sure. That's right. Mr. Fuhrer, so what are the guidelines for setting prices? When does it become gouging?
Well, again, it becomes gouging if the sale, if the price is greater than 10% more than the price was last week, or if the seller is selling for the first time and the price is more than 50% more than they've had to charge to get in the first place. So again, I'm thinking that if a seller is selling the average priced test kit in the $10 to $20 range, if a test kit is selling for $40 or $50, we are above that level and someone should contact our office so we can investigate and get this right. Because I will tell you, at the beginning of the pandemic, when price gouging was surrounding PPE, you know, masks and hand sanitizers and so forth, no office in the country was more impactful than ours in going after price gouging online or in brick and mortar stores. We're going to revive that effort now to tamp down price gouging for test kits in the same way we did for hand sanitizer.
And what about the punishment? What could people who do price gouge be facing?
Well, under Governor Newsom's order, a $1,000 penalty or 6 months in jail for each violation. And I will say, before we sign off, I do want to point out, in addition to price gouging, I want to be sure that people who are getting test kits are getting legitimate test kits. And I want to point out that the Federal Food and Drug Administration has on its website a list of tests that are authorized by the FDA. I choose the word authorized on purpose. The FDA does not approve these tests now. So if you see, as I'm holding up here, a test kit that says FDA emergency use authorized, then this is a good test. If someone is trying to sell you a test that says FDA approved on it, that's a good sign that it is not a legitimate test. And we know that we have to be getting accurate results from these tests to protect our loved ones and our coworkers and our friends in the community.
Yeah, didn't know that.
And neither did I. That's really interesting, actually. What about enforcement, Mr. Fuhrer? Are we there out there in Los Angeles checking out businesses to make sure they're complying?
Well, at this point, we're relying on complaints, which is why this public service that you're performing today is so important, allowing us to get the word out to consumers to contact us if they are concerned that price gouging has happened. And by the way, if they are concerned about that, they don't need to have purchased an overpriced item. You can take a screenshot from the internet You can, if you do purchase it, you can get a receipt from a store. It's particularly helpful if they can identify what the price was before January 8th, because we can compare that price to the price being offered today. And we're then going to investigate. And as we did in the pandemic earlier for masks and hand sanitizer and other issues, we will prosecute or pursue civil action. We were previously able not only to stop practices again and again, but also get restitution for customers. And I'm very proud of that work. As I said earlier, though, I would much rather stop it in its tracks so that no one is victimized by this practice than I would to prosecute someone after there's been a victim. Because at that point, we're trying to get things back together again after someone has suffered. We can do better than that here, and I'm hoping we can.
All right. City Attorney Mike Fuhrer, thank you so much for being with us today and for that valuable information.
It's great being with both of you. Good luck to all of you.
Thanks so much.